Hey guys, so welcome to our show, The Human Chain. And this is a very special show where we actually tell you stories about people who are doing ground level work in this pandemic, in this COVID-19. Because, you know, COVID-19 has affected our lives, our daily lives, but it has affected daily workers' life and how we don't even know the challenges they are facing right now. And somehow hum ghar pe sochte hain baith ke ki hum kya kar sakte hain yaar, hum ghar pe to lockdown mein to band hai, but actually coming to think about it, you can do a lot of things ghar pe baithe, even if it's very very little. And actually isi soch ke sath इंडिया में काफी सारी चीजें हो रही हैं, स्पेशली धारावी की जब हम बात करते हैं तो वहाँ के कुछ कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने अपने पॉकेट मनी से जो है दे स्टार्टेड फीडिंग धारावी. बिकॉज लेट्स फेस इट, धारावी में इतने सारे लोग हैं जो डेली वर्कर्स हैं, जिनकी लाइफ इज सस्टेन डे टू डे लाइफ में होती है. सो टुडे आई हैव विद मी स्टैनली हु इज अ सोशल वर्कर, और आई शुड से अ रियल सुपर हीरो, बिकॉज ही इज गोइंग आउट देयर and helping people, feeding Dharavi. The concept is feed Dharavi. मैं और उनसे जानना चाहूंगी, और अगर आप ये सोच रहे कि मैं कैसे help कर सकता हूँ उन लोगों को, so you've tuned in correctly because I'm going to be giving you all the information. In fact, Stanley is going to be giving you all the information. So happy to have you, Stanley. Thank you so much. And बहुत thank you बोलना is not enough, but thank you दिल से for doing all this for this unprecedented time, you know. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much for actually inviting me and for reaching out, and more than that, you know, for understanding that how big a challenge this is, and for simply acknowledging that. Because yes, the lockdown, it's something that none of us ever expected. It's a challenge that everyone, you know, each one of us are facing the world over. But somewhere we have to understand that there are certain economic classes of people for whom it's become a question of survival. It's not about boredom. It's not about getting adjusted to a new level. So that's something that, you know, I just wanted to put across.
Yeah, absolutely. I totally agree, because hum to ghar mein baith ke work from home kar sakte hain. पर वो लोग जो रोज बाहर निकलते हैं, जिनका काम ही दिन हर दिन के उस पे चलता है, वो खाना ही एक दिन के उस पे करता है. सो टेल मी स्टैनली, ये जो कॉलेज स्टूडेंट्स हैं, आई मीन hats off to them, how did they even think apni pocket money se feed karna, how did they come to you, how did this start, tell me all that.
Right, okay, so just a brief background. So I was with a company in Bombay, and so a couple of years back, these group of students, you know, they walked in for an interview for a part-time job.
Okay.
And then when I found out that they were from Dharavi, so I said, so somehow I give them preference, you know, because these kids deserve a chance.
Yeah.
So they started working and all that. So eventually, you know, the process shifted out, and you know, they had to quit and all that. But over the last couple of years, they've been in touch with me. We developed a kind of a connection. So
okay.
I used to, you know, just simple stuff, like they used to call me up, sir, kaun sa course karna chahiye, kya karna chahiye. I used to just encourage them. Mm-hmm. So what happened in this lockdown was, only a day or two into the lockdown, the kids realized that hunger is becoming a real thing in Dharavi, because they were not allowed to get out. And especially in Dharavi, the lockdown is even more strict, because everyone knows that, you know, in crowded places, the spread of the virus is always. That way, Dharavi is probably the worst hit in the world if you consider, you know, the population and the geographical area. It's so constrained. It's so, you know. So only a couple of days into the lockdown, the kids, they saw around and they realized that, you know, there are families who are already going without food. So what they did was they pooled in whatever savings they had. And one of them said that, you know, we took our pocket money in advance from our parents. And then we tried to tell them that, you know what, we are not going to be going out anymore. We are not going to be spending on this. And so give us our money in advance and we'll do this. So what they did was they supported about four or five families out of their own pocket money in the beginning. And then they realized that this is absolutely not going to be enough. And then they came up with a list of, you know, families who were already running short, who really needed the food, just basic food supplies at least. So they gave me a call and they asked me, so is there something that you can do? So at that time, we never ever thought of reaching out to others. At that time, we thought that, okay, this is only about a few families, right? So maybe we can handle it between ourselves.
Okay.
So I told them, you know what, just run a small informal survey in your neighborhood and see how many families are there who actually need our help. And then we'll, you know, I'll do what I can do. So they came up with that survey, then they came up with a list of about 25 to 26 families. So then we said, okay, so there are ladies in our home. So now how much does it total to be put into it? So then we ran some numbers, we ran some calculations, and for 1,720.
Oh, wow. That's a lot of
20 rupees.
Yeah.
Yeah. So for 1,720 rupees, we realized that we could buy them enough for about a month. And So me and I had to, of course, reach out to a couple of my friends, because I'm not a saving kind of guy. So even I was falling short of fun. So I reached out just to a couple of very close friends and I said, see, this is something that we need to do. If the kids in Dharavi, you know, who we think that do not really have, you know, that foresight or, you know, that kind of emotional connect with people, if they can come up with such an idea where they want to do something for the community despite having no resources whatsoever.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we are, of course, a lot more blessed than them. So hamara to banta hi hai ki hum unki madad kare.
Definitely.
So we did that. Yeah, we helped around 25 families. Abhi iske beech kya hua? Jab hum ye supplies de rahe the ye families ko, people around came to know ki, you know, yahan pe hai jo thoda bahut madad kar rahe local. Then, you know, they started lining up. And so genuine causes. So every day we heard these stories. So over 2 or 3 days, I heard so many stories that I said, no, this has to be taken on to another level.
Yeah.
Because people are genuinely suffering. So let us give it a try. So at that time, we thought, ठीक है, 25 families का हमने already कर दिया है. चलो और एक 10-15 families का तो हम कर ही लेते हैं.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you said 1,000 families around, right? You said there were 1,000 people already who were on the on the edge of ki humko khana shayad nahi mile.
Okay, so what happened? So Dharavi is a huge place. It's a huge place, and it's divided. And there are places in Dharavi where, you know, one person wouldn't know what the other area is like or what kind of people stay. So even though it's only a 2.1 square kilometer, the radius of that entire thing is 2.1 square kilometers. But it's a very complex lifestyle over there.
Yeah.
Everything is very complex. You know, there are separate communities. So one community will live in one particular section of Dharavi and all these kind of things. So this survey that these children ran initially, they realized that, okay, there are about 1,000 to 1,200 people. So that's, those were the immediate ones who required our help. So that is the initial count that they had come up with.
Okay.
But of course, I'm talking about a phase which was only about 2 or 3 days into the lockdown.
Yeah.
And of course, as time went by, that multiplied, man. That multiplied, because here we are talking about people who, even if they go without work for 2 or 3 days, it becomes difficult for them to survive. And now they have gone without work for weeks and months.
A month.
So you can imagine, you know, how challenging the scenario has become for them.
Pretty sure. And the cases obviously were higher. They started building up, so they couldn't go out anywhere. But tell
they
me,
couldn't,
Pani,
yeah.
These amazing kids, you came in the picture, you started helping, you started posting it on Twitter. And that's how people reached out to you and started helping. So tell us, what's your Twitter handle? We all can follow you and then we can all help you out.
Oh, cool. So I gave them the name Dharavi Boys because they are from Dharavi. And they are these group of kids who, you know, so I said, okay, Dharavi Boys. So Dharavi Boys is what they are known as on, at Dharavi Boys on Twitter. You can find them on Twitter. On Insta also, you can find them at Dharavi Boys. On Facebook, you can find them at Feed Dharavi. Feed Dharavi is what we are calling our initiative. because eventually that's what we are doing. We are trying to feed the families and that.
Most important question, Stanley. I'm pretty sure sab log ye bol rahe honge, Isha ye question kyun nahi puch rahi ki how can they help them out now? Because you said 1700 rupees, sirf itne se amount se bhi shuruaat ki ja sakti. To kaise log donate kar sakte hain? What I also like is that you have a very transparent operation, so there's no there's no two way of thinking ki are kya hoga. So it's reaching out to correct people, it's getting to people you want them, feed them. So tell us all that detail. How can we donate? How can we reach out to the correct person?
Right. Okay. So Isha, I realize that when we are asking people. Help us with their hard-earned money. Mm-hmm. It is also our duty to make things as transparent as possible. Mm-hmm. Because even if someone donates 1 rupee, we are answerable to them for that 1 rupee. They have the right to know what happens to the 1 rupee. And it's a very natural thing, na? If I am helping someone, I would like to know how it has gone forward. I wouldn't want everything to end at a thank you. Mm-hmm. So what we have devised is a very simple system. Where we make everything very transparent. So until now, all the families that we have helped until now. So today, we just distributed the supplies to our 225th family.
Wow.
So where at one point where 25 was seeming impossible to us, but somehow we pushed ourselves, and we have had so many people join us in this endeavor. Mm-hmm. So we have distributed, and the details for all these 225 families are on our Instagram account, mm-hmm. and they are on our Facebook account. So mm-hmm. we have the images of all the families, we have the names of all the families, so people know that when we say 225, they are right there for people to see. In fact, mm-hmm. I encourage people to go ahead and see all those photographs, because these are real people who. The people who are well-to-do, we have helped these people, in getting at least those basic food supplies to survive. So I think all of us should also have that satisfaction that, these are the families that we have helped,
Yeah,
that was really encouraging.
It's like knowing personally that, this is the family.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. So I would really encourage people to go ahead and do that. Apart from this, after every milestone, so say after we reach the last update that I had on the accounts was when we put up everything, how much we have spent. So we actually have the amount that we have spent on rice, the amount we have spent on dal, the amount that we have spent on oil. So we have those entire details that people can go through. That, mm-hmm. So they know, this is exactly what is happening. Mm-hmm. Because I seriously believe that, transparency is key, man. Transparency builds trust.
Yeah.
It's good to tell people what you are doing with their money, and it will always be their money. Yeah. We are just a channel. We are just, trying to organize things and trying to, streamline everything.
Yeah.
So that is one thing. So when it comes to transparency, we have actually had people, come up to us and tell us that this is the first operation that they are seeing of this kind, where, so much of information is being available to them.
Yeah.
But that's how we had decided. Yeah.
Yeah.
But we had decided from the beginning only.
That's the best thing. Right. Donating, or you want people, you want to feed them. You just question yourself. Ye sahi jagah ja raha hai. Ye.
Exactly.
So I think it's a great
exactly.
Done. Yeah. Now where can they donate? Thank
you. Okay. So so we set up a page on Keto because initially only I had a few friends in the US and in the UK. Mm. So when they heard about this, they wanted to help. So I knew that we had to have something online. So I set up a page on Keto and I created a Bitly link. So our link is bit.ly/feeddharavi. Very simple, very easy to remember. bit.ly/feeddharavi. So people can come there. Again, even on that page, there is a lot of information. there is an actual breakup of, you know, what we give these families for 1,720 rupees. And do people have to donate exactly that amount? Absolutely not. They can donate any amount that they are comfortable with.
Okay.
See, even if it's 100 rupees, for me, that 100 rupees translates to 20 packets of Parle Ji biscuits.
Yeah, it's how I see it.
So anything that comes in eventually is going to translate into some kind of food supply for these families. So it's not at all about how much. It's all about, you know, that thing of just helping out. Just every bit helps.
Absolutely. And this is what I'm saying. Like when you sit at home and just think, "Hum kya kar sakte hain?" So definitely, can you repeat the link once again so people can know and they can go and donate stuff?
Yeah, Isha, the link is bit.ly/feeddharavi. FEEDDHARAVI.
Perfect. And go and follow them on Instagram, Dharavi Boys, and go and follow them on Twitter. You will see every information. You will see kisko aap feed kar rahe ho, kaun si family ko kaun sa khana ja raha hai. To aapko bhi khushi hai, aur khushi sabse zyada ye hai ki un logo tak khana pahunch raha hai. So that's Stanley, I can't thank you enough. Yeah. Thank you so much for taking out
this initiative. Thank you so much.
And helping so many people. And because of you, we can actually join in this cause and, you know, help as little as
possible. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Isha. Thank you for this opportunity. And so, yeah, Isha, so that is where, you know, we are facing our biggest hurdle.
Yeah.
Because, you know, all of us, we have a very limited set of contacts. Yeah. Yeah? Especially the kids from Dharavi, they hardly know anyone from the outside world. Yeah. So it's impossible for them to reach out. But what about us? We at least have, you know, any one of us, we have at least, you know, 1,000 contact numbers maybe on our phone.
Right.
You know, we have. So even if all of us decide that, you know what, let me tell everyone I know about this particular initiative.
Mm.
Even if they do that, you can imagine, you know, how many people will get to know about it. And, you know, once they get to know, see, we have had this experience. Once people get to know, they automatically come in and they want to help in any way that they can.
But letting
them in on, you know, this entire initiative, the Feed Dharavi initiative, is where we are falling short. So your, you know, you reaching out to us and you giving us this platform, I'm pretty sure it's going to be a huge boost to this entire thing.
I hope that from my heart that people should reach out and help as much as we can, because if we are in a grateful situation, this is least we can do. So
thank you so much, Isha.
Of course. No, thank you so much. And you guys, I'll put the link where you can actually go and donate again. Go and follow them on Twitter, Dharavi Boys. And stay tuned for this Human Change show, because like Stanley, we'll be bringing a lot of people here who are actually helping at ground level. So thank you so much for watching this. Thank you so much, Stanley, for giving
your
time. And you guys stay tuned and keep listening to Radio Zindagi.